This is the final image of a beautiful monkey taken in Japan. But this was the image I started out with. And I couldn't believe it either. My name is Philipp and I'm a Germany-based photographer, and to be honest, I was sure this image is completely lost. But Luminar Neo makes it super easy to edit stunning wildlife photos like this one. If you're looking for inspiration, editing techniques, or simply want to have a look at Luminar Neo, this is the right place. Let's edit us some monkey. If we remember the final image, we basically need to turn the photo around. What's dark right now has to be bright, and the other way around. Let's start with the raw develop module and keep an eye on the histogram. We open up the shadows, add a touch of exposure, completely take out the highlights, reduce the whites basically completely, and bring the blacks up a touch. Let's also head to the colors and push the temperature a little towards the blue and the tint a little towards magenta. And let's also move that mouse to the subscribe and like button to support the channel. Okay, well done. Look at that. With just that one module, we basically made this into a workable image. There is much more to do though. That stone here in the foreground is super bright, so we need to bring that down. Let's create another develop module and bring down the highlights fully, the shadows a little bit, and also bring down the whites all the way. Now, we don't want this everywhere, so let's head to masking, select the gradient mask and bring the adjustment into the foreground. Because we darkened things down quite a bit, the colors changed with it. So one more minor adjustment to make here is to bring down the saturation and the vibrance. At this point I wondered, can we make the head of our monkey a little bit larger? Sure we can. Remember, the viewer has no reference point in the image, no reference size, no nothing. Only we know the original proportions, and if we don't go super mad, then nobody will notice, but it'll look better. So let's use another develop module and head to optics. Here, drag the lens distortion slider a little towards the left. This will essentially enlarge the middle portion of the image, which just so happens to be our head. Now, to make the photo pop, we need to separate our subject from the background a bit more. The background is still super bright, so let's bring that down to make sure our monkey is brighter, using yet another develop module. And once again, highlights all the way down, smart contrast a bit down, whites all the way down, and saturation down. Of course, we don't want to affect our little friend here, so let's head to masking, select the brush, and brush over the background. Thanks to the fur, we don't have to be super accurate here. This looks okay, but we can make it so much better. Check it out. First, do you see the branch and the sort of wisdom eyebrows here? We need to remove those things because they're distracting. Let's select the erase tool and go over the branch and each single strand of hair. Boom, gone. Awesome. The image doesn't have a super obvious focus point yet, so let's create one. I'll use a vignette adjustment, bring the slider to the left, feather a little bit, and increase the inner light a little bit. This already makes the fella pop a good amount more because now the light centers around him. Her? Am I gonna gender a monkey? Anyway, we haven't done much with the colors yet. Most of what we just did was for the light. So I remember there was a LUT that would fit this image very well. So let's head to mood and select the candlelight LUT and bring the saturation down a bit, maybe to minus 38. And let's also set the amount a little bit lower to 19. Now this particular effect is only for our monkey. So let's head to masking, select the brush and paint the mood in. It just makes him pop a bit more. Let's close that mood adjustment and create another one for the overall image. This time we'll select the Los Angeles LUT and leave it at around 30. Now to make the monkey pop a bit more, we can adjust the contrast so that it pops more away from the background. So let's create, yet again, a develop module, pull down the blacks and bring up the whites. Let's bring that into the monkey with a brush and check this out. This really lets the subject stand out a bit more. Now, the stone here in the lower part is still a bit distracting, so let's create a structure adjustment and bring the structure down. This will make the surface smoother and therefore draw less of the eye. So let's use a brush to paint that into the stone. And there we go. Look at that overall before and after. It's mad, isn't it? Now you can go on your next safari, the zoo, or simply the great outdoors and easily fix those dark wildlife images with Luminar Neo. If you like Luminar, make sure you use the link in the description as well as the promo code LETSIMAGE at checkout to save $10 or euro or whatever your currency might be. As always, until next time, stay safe and have a good one.